I would like to greet everyone with the love of Jesus Christ. I came here with desire and willingness to continue that seminar which we had in Savar in January. And I understand that most of you, majority of you was not there. And because of that, I am thinking that maybe just a few words I will tell you main idea of what was in that seminar. We were talking about biblical salvation. Because you see, there is one interesting thing which I saw in among many Christians. Majority of Christians believe that there is one text in the Bible which is the most important. Do you know the text? Which is the most important text in the Bible? Who knows? Who will tell it?
John 3:16.
For God so loved the world that gave His only begotten Son. He gave His only begotten Son in order that whosoever will believe in Him would not perish but have everlasting life. So you know this verse? Yes?
Yes.
Who does not know this verse? Everyone knows. Sure. That's because all Christians believe that this is verse number one. But you know what? This text says what Jesus did at the beginning to provide us opportunity to be saved. But this verse does not tell what I supposed to do to be saved. Yes, it says that everyone who believe in Him would have the everlasting life. But what does it mean to believe in Him? Can anyone say exactly what is that believe in Jesus? So because of that, I think for myself that there is another verse in the Bible which I think the most important verse. And this is John 17:3. And it says in John 17:3, If you have your Bibles, you can open it and read it. And John 17:3 tells us, this is the eternal life. Let them know you, the only God. And another one whom you sent is Jesus Christ. So this verse tells us what is exactly makes us living eternally. It is if we know God and if we know Jesus. Now, do you know me? You saw me? You heard about me from some people were telling about me? Now I came here, I told you about myself. Do you know me? Can you say that you know me? Can you say if I am good person or bad person? Can you say if I have good character or bad character? Do you know how I may react in some hard situation? No, you really don't know me. In Russia, we have such saying. If you want to know a person, you have to eat together with him 10 kilos of salt. And you cannot eat that salt with spoon. Just little bit each time. So do you understand what does it mean to know another person? I live with my wife already 23 years. And sometimes I think, oh, I live with her 23 years, I know her. And suddenly something happens. And I look at her and I think, do I know her? You understand that? Because you also live in the family. And you know that sometimes you do not know exactly your parents, though you grow up with your parents. Sometimes parents think that they know their children and suddenly their children do something strange. Now return back. We are talking about eternal life. And Bible says, in fact, these are words of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ says that eternal life, that is salvation, is to know God and to know Jesus. What should I do to know Jesus? What should I do to know God? You know, there in the Old Testament, before Jesus Christ came to this earth, Moses received from God information how to build sanctuary.
এবং মুসি যে শুনিয়ে যে মাখা বারকে যে সমগম তাম্বু অবনতান খায়.
And that sanctuary, it was piece of land surrounded by fence.
এবং খা যে just হাসমান ওয়াকে ঘুরাই অঙ্গই দাঙ্গাত সমগম তাম্বু.
And there on that piece of land was tent, small tent house.
এবং খা যে ইয়াকে বারকে দোসলা আকে অঙ্গই রোজাত সমগম তাম্বু.
On the yard here in within that fence there were two things.
এবং যে অবনি দুগলামো অর্থাৎ বারান বারান্দা গো অরব যে মানে কাই জঙ্গো.
That was an altar on which they were bringing offerings to God.
এবং অর অঙ্কা যে একটা মানে তমো যে ওটাই বড় বিভিন্ন শাক সবজি বা নখংখানের উৎসর খাইনাম তৈফায়ও.
And that offering was some kind of animal which supposed to die for my sins.
অবঙ্গ কিছু কিছু উৎসবতম যে হয়তো কিছু মানে হয়তো পূরণ পুঙ্গ মানে বেড়া পুঙ্গ অবন তানে অবন পরিবর্তে চুং আকে মুক্ত ভাই আইজাতি.
And that symbolized Jesus who supposed to come later and die for our sins.
অবঙ্গ এক ধরনের চিহ্ন যে প্রভু যীশু খ্রিস্ট হলো ভাই নাই বহু চিহ্ন ভাই আকে ফিরে ভাই আইচুং মুক্ত ভাই.
So because of that, when anyone would commit some sin, they're supposed to take that animal and go to the sanctuary.
They're
supposed to confess their sin upon that animal and then kill that animal and bring it into offering. And with that they would confess they believe that Jesus sometime will come and die for their sins.
এবং গো আই ফুল শিকার খাইও এবং পাইতো গো যে ঠিক নিয়াইকে প্রভু যীশু খ্রিস্ট বলো খাইয়াই যে যিনি পাপ নি বাইচুং না আগে.
So that was in the yard of that sanctuary.
এবং গো সেই সমগম তাম্বনি বারান্দা আগে তঙ্গো.
But then there was that house made of tent. And in that house there were two departments, two rooms. In one of those rooms, priests supposed to do daily ministry for them.
যাজক হলে বস বস বসে মাখাবো এবং বস সবসময় বরমনি বাই ওর অঙ্গ মাখেও.
এভরি ডে এ প্রিস্ট সাপোজ টু এন্টার দ্যাট স্যাংচুয়ারি
এবং সালপুটি ওর আকে ওসাই মাখাবো.
এন্ড বাই দ্য ওয়ে আই ফরগট টু টেল ইউ ওয়ান স্মল ডিটেইল
এবং আং কাইসা অঙ্গ সামান নং পালকা.
When that sinner was would bring this animal and kill him and bring on the altar
এবং ও পাপি যে পাপ খানে বো আকে তেলাই মাথাঙ্গো তেলাই থাই আগে মাতানায়ো পুরন তুমদের আগে মাতানায়ো ও আকে উৎসব খাই মারগো.
Both sinner and priest supposed to eat a little piece of that animal
এবং ও আগে তানে পেখাই ওর যে অসাইতম নাই আগে আর যে পাপ খাই বো তেলাই থাই বক চালানো কিজন কে সাই মানায়ো.
And that means that when sinner eat piece of that animal and that animal is sinless, he was not guilty, so that piece of meat of sinless animal enters into their person
এবং পাপ করে প্রাণী নি বাখান চিনি ওর হাবই থাঙ্গো.
And starts and you know as every food it takes part of a human person, let him grow
এবং চুন চিও যে যত মুইখান তো খেন তুন বা ফলন ফাংশন চাখাই অবচুন আস্তে আস্তে কে অঙ্গ টর্নান সাহায্য খায়ো.
And that animal symbolized Jesus.
এবং ও প্রাণী ওখা একেবারে যে যিশু নকশাল একটা উদাহরণ স্বরূপ কলে.
And that means when I come to Jesus, I have to what as we would say, to eat him. By the way, you remember when Jesus already after that established Lord's Supper. You remember what he was telling? I am the bread of life. And you have to eat my flesh. Well, he was telling this is in symbolical way. People who were listening to him said, what the strange words. But Jesus wanted to say, I want to start to become part of your whole life. Because that food which you eat, it, after it digests there, it goes through the blood on every point of your body. And because of that you grow. Because of that you turn healthy. Jesus wants us to enter into us and be our part. And with that we would grow spiritually. And we would change. So you see, the main point of this is not only that Jesus dies for our sins, but he fills us and changes our life into good. Now, the priest also ate a piece of that animal. But with the priest, that's a different symbol. Because priest was symbolizing Jesus himself. And now he is taking piece of that animal on which I confessed my sin. In fact, I exchanged with that animal. I took his righteousness and I gave him my sin. That's symbolically, of course. Animal cannot save me. That's simply a symbol that Jesus will supposed to come and take my sin upon himself and give me his righteousness. So now, priest symbolizing Jesus and Jesus had no sin. But because he symbolically ate my sin and takes it upon himself, he enters then into that sanctuary, and with him my sin enters into the sanctuary. You see, when I'm doing something wrong, it does not disappear simply so. If I'm hurting someone, doing something bad to another person, and after that I say, please forgive me. He might forgive me, but there is a bitterness which you cannot take away simply by forgiveness. You know, if I did something wrong, if I steal something, if I beat somebody, or even if I did something wrong that big that I killed someone. You may ask forgiveness a lot, but this will not be returned. You cannot feel that wound which you made, you cannot resurrect the person who you killed. You see, your sin and my sin as well is staying there, it does not disappear. Jesus takes it from me. Just now, he declares me not guilty. But someone supposed to respond for that. So he takes my sin there into the sanctuary. And there in the sanctuary, as I said, there were two rooms. In the first room, there were three objects. And these were also symbols. And we need to understand these symbols because Bible is written not just so we would have another book. Bible is the handbook of our salvation. And absolutely everything in the Bible counts for our salvation. And we cannot understand what we are supposed to do if we would read only that one text, John 3:16. So hear what is going on there. There were three objects. One was candlestick with light. Candlestick. Lights. Then second thing was table on which there were 12 breads. And there was another golden altar on which there was fume was constantly burning. So what does it mean altogether? That light means the Holy Spirit which enlightens us regularly. And that is that word of God which named as a light for us. And Jesus, and priest supposed to each morning go in and lighten those candles. And that means that daily, each morning, when we start our life, we're supposed to go to the Word of God. We're supposed to go to the Bible and read it daily. That's part of our salvation. Read your Bible every day. Why? To know God. To know Jesus. That's when He daily eat with us that big portion of salt, piece by piece. In the Bible we see the glory of Jesus. And in 2 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 18,
এবং দ্বিতীয় করিন্থীয় 3 অধ্যায় 18 পদে
God through apostle Paul was saying that when we look, when we behold his glory, we grow from the glory to glory into the same image.
এবং কাছেন যখন নপং জান কুরবানিত খাইছেনবো আস্তে আস্তে যে আকে কুরবানিত অঙ্গ.
When we look at Jesus, we tend to be the same like him.
তুমি যখন প্রভু শ্রী কৃষ্ণ আকে নং বাহাবাই চঙ্গো আস্তে আস্তে গরম বসল থাকো.
By the way,
যাও.
Did you pay attention by any chance?
এবং যে নক হয়তো চিন্তা রক্ষাই মানো.
That old people, husband and wife,
যত যে চালাপুরই,
they usually by the end of their life, they have completely similar character. They think equally. They talk equally. They act equally. Do you know why? Because they lived so long together, they began to look like one another. When we look, when we live together, we tend to copy one another. And that's why we need to live with Jesus always, so our character gradually, a little bit, would turn to be like character of Jesus. Well, maybe my character is not completely like character of Jesus. He is much better than me. But because of that, I am not stopping to read my Bible every day. I am still growing. And that's what you're supposed to do if you want to be eternal, you want to be saved and have eternal life. Now, there was another object in that sanctuary. And that object was table's bread. And do you know what? That bread on the table was changed every Sabbath. Once a week, every Sabbath, that bread supposed to be changed on that table. And in Revelation, we have such a saying about Jesus. And you, I am sure you know it. Because it says, Jesus tells us, I am staying by the door of your heart and knocking. If anyone will hear my voice and open me door, I will enter in and I will have supper with you. That's also symbolically. Because Jesus was always using these symbols, parables, proverbs to teach us those things which we cannot understand otherwise. You see, we like to communicate one with another sitting around the table. Because we are people. So our communication, we learn one another much more when we eat together. Because